Alrighty, what's up everyone? Austin here with another video review, and today we're going to be taking a look at Transformers, what we have been debating on calling it, Legion or minifigure, we don't exactly know, Starscream. And I have a special guest with me, which is Evie4i. Say hello, my friend.
Hello, my friend. How's everybody doing? I'm really excited about this. We're going to take a look at this figure, and what a better review to really kick things off with Starscream.
There you go, well said, yes. Here we have Starscream. He has a very nice little jet. I think he looks very G1 accurate.
He does, he looks good. I like the colors. I think the red and the purple Decepticon symbols look good. There's no question with you holding this plane that you're looking at Starscream here.
Exactly, and of course he will have the identification number, or the product number, whatever, but that doesn't really matter. The engraved number on the side as well. Now, of course, before we take a look at the figure, now we're going to pretty much gripe or complain about the packaging a little bit. It does have a very nice picture of Starscream there, as you can see. Starscream in his jet mode. Now, what do you have to say, Evie4i, about this picture of Starscream here?
First of all, Starscream is a very conniving individual, a very conniving bot. And I don't know why this package, it's a very nice piece of artwork, but it's like he went to glamour shots. You know, like, I'm half expecting him to lift his collar up and wink at the camera. It's too cute. I wish it was just a little bit more conniving. But it's a good piece of art. I'm not sure if we're looking at a Generation 1 Starscream. What do you think about that?
I think we're kind of looking at more of, like, on Fall of Cybertron level.
IDW.
Or IDW, yeah. Somewhat.
Yeah, he's got, it's really hard to tell because the way the box looks, you're cutting off his body, you can't quite see what's going on in his cockpit section under his face.
Yeah.
But overall, it's a nice piece of artwork, just a little too cute for me.
It looks like he is smiling a bit, doesn't he? He doesn't look too evil. Come around here to the back, we do have his jet mode and his robot mode, and of course his technical data, if you'd like to pause and read that, if it's easily seen. We have the instructions on the back, which are not that bad, and of course, we're all going to point out that it says reveal the shield, and he's not. This is the reveal the shield figure. What do you have to say about this reveal the shield thing?
You know, I don't know why they would call it that, because there's no shield to reveal. I mean, it's a Decepticon symbol. If you're going to call it reveal the shield, then put the rub symbols on. Now, I'm not a huge fan of rub symbols, because my hands are always cold and I can't really ever make a change. But I like the concept of it. I don't understand why you'd call it that without the reveal the shield stickers.
You know what you say with the cold hands, you know, there's always a saying that says cold hands, warm heart.
I think in my case, I it might be cold hands, cold heart.
Okay. Oh well, yeah, let's just go with that. Anyhow, so they were done with the box. I think we've kind of complained about it enough. Oh yeah, and of course, I forgot to mention, this is going to be sideways a bit because of the way the camera is. They're showing Transformers 4 Optimus and Transformers 4 Bumblebee. There's Optimus, there's Bumblebee there. What do you think about these spoiler shots of Optimus and Bumblebee?
You know, I think more so than spoilers, I think Hasbro's just looking for a way to save money and put as many types of figures and Starscreams in this package as they can. So if they want to release a Legion-size Age of Extinction Starscream or a Legion-size Fall of Cybertron Starscream, throw them in the same box. You have characters from all the different series, and they saved $1.50. So I don't know. I think it's all money-saving. It's a cool box, but a bit all over the place, unless they're taking the stance of 30th anniversary, let's throw a little bit of everything in there, in which case, kind of cool.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's pretty cool. My brother was pointing out something to me. What is it?
Side. No, other side.
Like this?
No,
right here. Okay, it says Decepticon there. It says Sabotage Specialist. So that's what he is. That's what my brother was pointing out.
Somebody sabotaged his glamour shot, because again, too cute.
Yeah, have you ever seen that show on Animal Planet, Too Cute?
No,
that's what Starscream's on, I swear to God.
Very nice. Yes.
Anyhow, so here we come to the figure. Finally, it's Starscream, and he's okay in his jet mode. Like before, I said it is G1-esque Starscream. This is definitely the Starscream of which all fans have been wanting in their collection. Is a miniature G1 version of Starscream. Now we haven't gotten this version, which is the rub symbol one, which yet again, a lot of people can never get these things to work. And right now my hands are actually really cold because, you know, I do my reviews in my basement, so it's not going to work in my basement. But this summer I'll be moving up into my bedroom. Yes.
A warm environment.
Exactly. That way these rub symbols will actually work.
And your family will feed you food. You're moving up from the depths of the basement into actual civilization.
Hey, I do not live in the basement. That's the joke my mom always says. I'm not even kidding. She's like, you're going to end up living in my basement. I'm like, Mom! Anyhow, there is something between these two. We do have the Decepticon symbols, of course, which look very nice. And we do have what look to be the holes here, which this one doesn't have. And then the holes here, which this one doesn't have. And that's the reason, because they released the molded Thundercracker one with the holes in it, with the null rays.
This figure looks real good, and I see that you pointed out the holes. Definitely a fan of the Decepticon symbol painted on versus the rub symbol. I think that looks beautiful. Yeah.
Now, I just gotta say, sorry to interrupt, the holes, actually there's a first, second, and third Starscream. We don't have the second one, we have the first and the second, first and third, my bad, I'm sorry. The second one came out and it actually had little, like, guns that actually attached underneath his wings, and that's why the peg holes are there.
True. True. There's gonna be different plastic here, of course, the different colors. This one's more of a silver, this one's more of a gray, but that's okay. This one's a whole cone of gray. This one has black, which comes in handy for robot mode, if you can't tell the difference already. So that's going to be pretty cool looking. So now we're going to go ahead and get this guy out of the way, and my brother's going to transform him while I transform this guy. To transform him, what you want to do is just kind of unpeg his legs from here. That's what I always like to do first, and kind of bring them out and about.
I will say while you're doing this that the screws joints that they have in there are kind of reflecting off my view of the review, and that's one of those things where you're not going to get good screw coverage on this class of figure, but overall it doesn't detract too much for me, but it is there and noticeable.
Wait, what are you talking about when you say about the screws?
On the flip side, if you turn them back over.
Oh yeah.
Right in there, your light hits it a certain way, and it's almost like you've got these four bright lights or five bright lights hitting the camera.
Like a UFO.
And it's just, like a UFO. And it's just that exposure that you get with this class of figure. I don't expect, you know, a ton of posability and covered screws with the Legion class, but maybe an issue for some people, so worth pointing out.
Yeah, that's actually a very good thing to point out there. I mean, we do have an actual screw here, but then you have, like, the pin things of which go to make things move. So, yeah, with this one, they didn't even cover them up on this guy either.
Yeah.
To reveal the shield one. So, yeah, that was a good thing to point out there. But anyhow, pretty much this is him in his robot mode now. And, of course, posability. I mean, you're just going to have a ball joint here, in and out there, bend at the knee. You know, the head's going to pivot. And here's where that black came in, is this guy never had the sides of his head painted, but they decided to paint the sides of this guy's head to make his whole head black. What do you think about that?
So much better. It's funny how just a little bit of paint can add so much difference, but with the entirety painted in black, it really brings that out in a good way. So well done.
Yes, I have to say, Hasbro did a really good job with this figure. They really did. I mean, I really do like the look of this, and like you before I said, and I have said about his head, just that little bit just made him look so much better. Here he looked like they just kind of chopped off the sides of his head. But then here, they look like they actually added the sides of his head back on. So that's what I really like about him. And yeah, so here's a comparison side by side. And of course it will be that, I don't know why this is getting, there we go. Okay, of course there will be different colors. I don't know why these guys' legs aren't standing like they should. Different colors. Just in the plastic, I believe that's the only difference in color that I've actually noticed. I'm not sure. And then, of course, the head with the side bits painted, which is a good thing. We also have what my brother would like me to put on the side is the miniature Optimus, which is also from this line. So there he is. And this guy's not going to stand on his own, actually. It's kind of unfortunate. His legs on mine are really loose. And I don't know why. I mean, I can kind of get him to stand. Maybe. There we go. So there we got that. I mean, that's a good comparison. I mean, Optimus is, of course, going to be a bit taller than Starscream. But yet again, Starscream isn't really standing up straight. I actually kind of had to move him around a bit in order to stand him up. So it actually looks okay.
They look good together. I think, you know, I mean, you're not going to get scale or two scale items at this level. Optimus, I think, should be a good bit taller than Starscream. But standing next to each other, they don't look bad. And again, there's no question who we're looking at here. And from a collector standpoint, or even a kid standpoint of putting these things up on a shelf, they do complement each other pretty well.
Yeah. Yet again, there's just going to be minor things about this guy that I'm just going to complain about. Would be the leg. It's a bit loose on mine. I really don't know why. I mean, other than that, I mean, nothing else really to complain about. I mean, really.
Yeah, the unfortunate thing with joints like that, and it's hard to say since this is the third release of Starscream, you might have some mold degradation, especially with the small-scale joints. You can maybe touch that up with a little bit of furniture polish or super glue, but always beware when you do that. If the ball joints aren't strong enough, you could twist them right off. So definitely be careful, but there may be some self-improvement that can be done on this guy to help stand him up. You shouldn't have to do that, but you know, if you can't stand up your Starscream, that might be something you want to try out.
Yeah, and besides, it's not even a ball joint. That's another thing.
Yeah, hard for me to see on this angle. If it's not a ball joint, you definitely need to be careful in trying to stiffen that up.
Yeah, it's more of a swivel joint than anything there on his hip.
Yeah, it's certainly not impossible, but you definitely want to be careful because you're not going to be too happy if a little bit of glue ruins your figure. I noticed you got him in a bit of a cone head there.
Yeah, I know. That's what I was doing. I mean, he looks like he's ready for a party, or maybe he's a conehead. So, I mean, if so...
Detention.
If so, or he's wearing the dunce cap. I mean, whatever.
I'd like to see the cone... So, it looks to me like they could do some conehead seekers.
They could.
And they'd look pretty good. That doesn't seem to look too bad.
Yeah, I mean, if they really wanted to. Now, I mean, it depends on who we'd see. Is it Thrust that's a conehead, right?
Yes, I'd love to see a Thrust in this scale.
A mini Thrust. And I think he's red, right? If I'm not mistaken.
He is. He's like a real dark burgundy red, yes.
Yeah, that color.
He's a really nice character.
I don't think
he's pretty cool. Thrust.
Yeah, you haven't seen him. I mean, you've seen him, but you don't know the character of him. Yeah.
I've seen him.
You know, I've got a G1 Thrust literally sitting behind me, which I'll do a review at some point of some old figures. But I always was a fan of Thrust because of those blaze inside of his wings. Really cool. Yeah. Now, what do you think about the kibble on jet mode? Is this, you know, most Starscreams we're going to get some kibble underneath, but how do you feel it looks on this figure?
With this one, I mean, it's not that bad. I mean, now, of course, we're going to have his knee guards. I mean, come on, these are his legs. But that's the only thing that really hangs off. That's the only thing that really sticks out to me. I mean, maybe someone will pick on him and say about his feet or his hands. But really, and the cockpit, like with his head being there. But nothing else really stands out with me.
Now, do the knee guards act a bit as landing gear? Does it help balance him up when he's in jet?
Yeah, that's
perfect.
What
okay.
I thought those were for.
Yeah. Actually... This is going to be the end, because I can't upload 15 minutes or longer because of YouTube being stupid.
Darn
so, I know, man, we're going to have to do this again sometime. This is a lot of fun. Anyhow, guys, this has been Austin with a video review of Transformers, miniature figure of Starscream with EB4i.
And I think the consensus is we both recommend this figure.
Yeah, yes, we both highly recommend it. It's just going to be like... If yours is loose, that's going to be the ultimate little tidbit problem of what you're going to have with this guy. So, yeah, thanks for watching. Guys, go like us both on Facebook. go subscribe to us. All of our links will be down in the description below. And I'll talk to you guys later on another video review. Adios.